I've been playing the first Descendant final technical test this past few days, and this is my impression and experience of the game. This game is a third-person co-op action RPG looter shooter using Unreal Engine 5. Let's start with the system requirements and graphics. The system requirements for this game is actually not that high. You can play this game at the recommended settings with an Intel i7-7700K, which is an extremely old processor, and an AMD Ryzen 5 2600X. For the GPU, you can easily play this game at recommended settings if you have a NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2060 or AMD Radeon RX 5600XT. You also need at least 16 gigs of RAM, and I also highly recommend using a SSD or M.2 drive for storage and faster loading times. The game actual size right now is 50 gigs, but it's probably going to get bigger and bigger as updates and expansions are released. One issue I have with this game's graphics is when you lower the settings to high, the game starts to look grainy. Another issue is when it comes to cinematic cutscenes, the game locks the cutscenes at 30 FPS, making it stutter. Overall, the game runs pretty smooth, and I am pretty impressed the fact that this game is in its technical test phase. The First Descendant is a third-person action RPG, and this is my preferred gameplay when it comes to sci-fi looter shooter just like Warframe. One of the reasons why I don't like Destiny and Cyberpunk is that for some reason it's in first person and it's an RPG. I don't like playing RPG games where you can only see your hands and the game has a character customization. I like games where I can fully see my character, especially in RPG games. Cyberpunk has a character customization, the same with Destiny, but it is in first person, and I don't really see the point with that. RPG should be in third person because what is the point of scouring every nook and cranny of every dungeon and collecting weapons, armors, and trinkets, but in the end you can only see your hands and weapons. Also, if you haven't noticed, every MMORPG endgame is all about fashion. The gunplay in the First Descendant is pretty smooth and fun. It is just like Warframe but kind of slower in a good way. The guns perform pretty well and the sound effect is crisp. There are weapon customizations such as weapon level transmission, readjustment, enhanced unique ability, and reactor enhancement. As of now, I don't really want to talk about the gun customization and character customization because I wasn't able to max out the characters of the Descendants that I have. I was only able to reach around Mastery Level 8 and Level 20 plus for each character in the 2-day technical test, and I don't think that is sufficient, but I was able to play 4 characters in the game and experience their abilities. I was able to try out different types of weapons and I have to say it is pretty damn amazing. There are a lot of weapons in the game and a lot of ways to customize it. Now, as I've said a while ago, I cannot go into full details about the customization simply because there was just not enough time. 2 days was just not enough and there are a lot of customizations, sockets, weapon improvements, and other things that I was not able to do simply because I lacked the mastery level. There are a lot of weapon types from assault rifles, submachine guns, hand cannons, handguns, sniper rifles, and rocket launchers. You can carry 3 weapons per character, and I really like the assault rifle, submachine gun, and the sniper rifle combination. There are also weapon rarity tiers from normal, blue, purple, and ultimate, which has a very low drop chance. You can also craft weapons, but you have to grind all the materials that you can find around the world. You can get materials from the story, quest, infiltration, and even boss fights. The game has a dodge roll mechanic and a grappling hook mechanic. You press dodge when you want to avoid AoE damage, and it is also a very good tool for repositioning. The grappling hook is also used for traversing the terrain and verticality of the map. My complaint about the grappling hook is that its range is pretty low even if you put a mod on it. I was able to increase its range around 25 meters and for me it was just not enough, and I hope they improve it. Descendants are what we call the playable characters in the first Descendant. There are 13 Descendants that you can choose from. From the 13, I was only able to try 4 of them. You can customize your Descendant or add mods to improve their attack damage, defense, lower ability cooldown, increase ability damage, or even lower ability energy consumption. You have to level up and grind materials for each Descendant. You also need mastery, which unlocks slots for mods just like in Warframe. You can also buy Descendants in the cash shop and you don't have to wait for hours while an NPC crafts the Descendant. Now, you can almost say that the first Descendant has way too many similarities with Warframe, and you are absolutely right about that. One of the Descendants that I really enjoy is Bunny the Speedster, and she is one of the best Descendants I've played so far. She is so fast and fun to play with, and there are times where you don't even have to use your weapons. Her first ability is Thrill Bomb. This ability deals damage to the nearest enemy and as of right now feels underwhelming. Her second ability is Speed of Light. This ability increases her sprint move speed and at the same time consumes MP. This ability builds electricity, increasing the damage to all of her other abilities. Her third ability is Lightning Emission. This ability deals AoE lightning damage around her, and the lightning damage is increased based on the electricity buildup. Combining her second and third ability makes Bunny one of the best AoE Descendants in the game. Her fourth ability is Maximum Power. She creates a beam of electricity dealing damage to enemies caught in the beam. This description is outdated and not the same as the one in the game. For some reason, the devs forgot to change the tooltip. Her fourth ability actually buffs Bunny, increasing her electricity buildup. There's a lot of Descendants in the game that I want to try out, but unfortunately I wasn't able to because the technical test only lasted for 2 days. In the future, I will cover all of them and try to make fun builds. There are also boss fights in the game. In the playtest, I was able to try 2 bosses and it was pretty fun. Bosses have weak spots and you can tell by pressing the tab button. It will highlight each boss's weak spot and once they are down, you can grapple to the weak spot and deal a decent amount of damage. One issue I had with the boss fight is that I always ran out of ammo and that was where the fun started to dissipate because I was just standing there doing nothing and all I'm trying to do is figure out how to get ammo. I don't really like the idea of having to conserve ammo when the boss is like a bullet sponge and the way you acquire ammo is by destroying the small adds. The issue is that the adds doesn't guarantee ammo drops. There are also supply depots that give you ammo and energy, but it has a cooldown. Now, these boss fights are done with low-level Descendants with low-level weapons with barely any modifications. And I do believe that it will get better as our level get higher. But the thing is that they should consider and improve the early game so that our expectations in the late game will be much better. Also, the early game should be the same quality as the late game because the early game is the part where the player is going to decide whether they are going to continue playing the game or quit the game entirely depending on their experience. I really enjoyed all the boss fights. It is easy to understand and I really like that you have a massive playing field where you can hide when doing boss mechanics. The bosses are also no pushover. If you don't do the mechanics, you will get knocked down. Getting knocked down means that you can still be revived by your teammates. You are also given 8 player chances when you die. As of now, there are only 2 bosses with 2 difficulty, normal and hard, but for sure, we are going to get more when the game releases in the future. We all know that the gaming company Nexon is notoriously known for their cash grab schemes, manipulating RNG and shutting down games when it is not making a lot of money. If you go to their Wikipedia page, you will see how many games they shut down after milking it to the absolute. Nexon is hated by most gamers, and that is why I am excited but at the same time extremely cautious about this game. And I hope to God that Nexon doesn't mess this up or get way too greedy. Deep down inside, I am truly excited for this game. I've been playing a lot of MMOs such as World of Warcraft, Black Desert Online, and Warframe. I am thirsty for another MMO, but I know that I should avoid riding the hype train. I am willing to give Nexon a chance, and I just hope that they won't do anything stupid like excessive monetization and RNG manipulation like what they did in MapleStory. The cash up in the first Descendant is a clear sign that this game is pay to win, even though this game is most likely going to be a PvE oriented game just like Warframe. I checked the cash shop and you can absolutely and clearly tell that there are stuff in there that can further yourself ahead from others if you pay money. And I even tried buying items in the cash shop in the final technical test because they were handing out free cash shop currencies as long as you play the game. You can buy items right away and upgrade your descendants and weapons. You can even buy descendants right away without grinding materials and waiting for a couple of hours crafting descendants. Annoyingly, this game has a battle pass, but that's just how things are nowadays since this game is free to play. The smartest thing to do is to not spend money in the game as much as possible. I would also like to tell everyone to be smart with their money. And if you ever want to buy something in the cash app, always remember that needs and wants are two different things. If you want something, then absolutely do not buy it. Only buy things that you need. Another issue I found in the cash shop is the school uniform skin, the firefighter skin, and the dinosaur pajama skin, which is incredibly ridiculous. I don't really care much about outfits and skin in game, but these things are so out of place. We are in a sci-fi settings and we are getting these ridiculous skins and it just doesn't fit the setting. I'm not saying that this doesn't exist in the future, but it probably wouldn't look like this. And also, why are we still getting costumes like these? It is like the company never moved on or never experienced high school or something. Every Eastern MMO has these weird out-of-place costumes that doesn't make sense and it definitely ruins the setting of the game. It is like they are not taking the game setting seriously. I'm totally fine with skins in game as long as it doesn't feel like it is out of place or the skin is in the wrong era. I know that there are players who like these kinds of skins, but every other MMO already has these skins. Almost every Eastern MMO has these skins and they are just boring to look at. The only reason why these kinds of skin exist is that there are players who like them. For me, these skins are cheap cash grab baits and it really diminishes the quality of the game in terms of visual coherence. Overall, as of now, there's really not a lot of game breaking issues that I can point out. But that is because it is way too early to tell and most of the things I have experienced are all in the early parts of the game. I just hope that we get a fun game with a good balance of cash shop items and I hope Nexon doesn't manipulate RNG. I am really excited for this game and I really hope that it doesn't turn into a quick cash grab game. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.